Hello, love. Welcome home to Eden. You have the hottest lover, guy, and for some reason, he ain't making you come. Oh, honey, what a frustration. He's your dream guy in so many ways, but that one essential way is not working out. Oh, nightmare. It's almost better he was not so perfect with what he could do them. One main job that you need done. All right, so let's talk about this, honey. This happened to me recently. I manifested dream guy, right? So handsome and hot, young, 15 years younger than me, and wiser than most older men, and I could respect his choices, and showering me with beautiful word flowers, and so fun to hang out with, and you know, he was a great lover. He was like, last forever, and oh my god, the most gorgeous cock you can imagine, that was like such a perfect fit for me. So why couldn't he get me to be multi-orgasmic like I usually was with my other lovers? You can imagine this was a little frustrating for him. Oh, so bad. But listen, we got through this, and I'm going to tell you how, because you can do this exactly what I did and explain it to him like this, okay? All right, there is such a thing as pussy-centered lovemaking. Now, it's completely the opposite of cock-centered lovemaking. However, the cock, in this instance, is used to having everything his way, always his priority as top. In other words, like lots and lots of, you know, getting to pump and grind for long periods of time, and you know, he'll go down quickly on the woman. Like if he's a good lover, he'll be like, okay, I spent 3 minutes, 3 to 5 minutes on spending on her is like an eternity to him. It's just like, do a little something so I can get back in. And it's nothing wrong with that, and you, girlfriend, may not even know anything other than that, because we're taught that that's somehow enough for us as women. But oh honey, there is another world on the other side of pleasure when he spends 20 minutes to a half an hour to an hour just pleasuring your pussy without doing any penetration, okay? Not even with fingers. This means it's all clitoral, it's labia, it's your boobs, it's your whole body, it's kissing with you, and then, you know, slipping and sliding his hands. And the thing is, it's slow. It does not have this fast pace of, like, you know, friction all over your clitoris to make you come. There is no agenda like that. Pussy-centered lovemaking is about flow, connection, and bliss that just keeps building. It's about surfing. He's surfing your energy, and he's taking you from a slow, delicate place up to a higher level where, yes, the pace is quicker and faster. He's taking you to the place where your pussy starts to talk to him, and he starts to feel the electrical synapses firing. Now, I did explain this to this one guy, and I am so proud of him for asking, because he asked me, he said, I feel like I'm doing something wrong. I feel like I could be doing better, and I just don't know what it is, because here he has been lasting for hours and hours, and so much connection and love, and I didn't want to say anything, because he's wonderful, you know? But he asked, so I explained it to him. Now, when he got the focus together, the devotion together, the passion together, to just be about being with my woman, my woman essence, what happened was, you know, the inside of your vagina, when the guy doesn't do enough time on you, real time without agenda, Your walls of your vagina are, it's like they're thin. They may be slippery because you're turned on. You are turned on by him. but they're thin and almost brittle. They almost have friction, and it's just there's not much sensation, and then we go a little numb interiorly to be able to handle all that friction. But darling, when that time is spent on you, the pussy starts to engorge with these pillows of love, and the clitoris starts to fire off these electrical fireworks all through your body. So now, when he came into me after doing all this for me, it was like I was completely out of hand. Like, it, just one entry and I was just completely in tears, like laughing, crying, shaking, because I had been woken up. Now my hunger for him is like rawr! So now if he goes out again and he goes back to pleasuring me and surfing that wave again and bringing me down to bring me back up, the next time I'm at a higher octave of the sensational ride, right? So if the guy could get with this pussy-centered lovemaking and keeping on doing this, where most of the time is spent on pussy rather than pumping and grinding, for one thing, it takes the pressure off him. He doesn't have to have a hard cock all that time, and he's a sex god without having to have that, right? So now, this all this time now for heart connection and eye contact and things, because he knows he's fulfilling you, so he can meet your eyes. You know, the thing is, in the world now, men want the feminine. It's not that they're bad lovers or ever were. It's just they were never taught anything different. They think, oh yeah, I gotta go to the feminine to get this thing I'm missing. I gotta get it. And so with cock-centered lovemaking, the focus is, I gotta get this. I gotta, you know, pump and enter and get. And they never do. It's a constant hunger. They never ever get to have that essence they're craving. It's when they focus on the feminine, and here's the paradox, on giving to her this experience, that they get what they came for. They get it in spades, and they get more and more. And now, now, girlfriend, you gotta explain it like that, okay? Or let them see this video, okay? It's not okay. It's not gonna be enough. Even if they're like really good at going down on you and they're like pretty passionate about it, but still, if the focus is on him getting back to the pumping thing and into entry, and that's supposed to be the real thing, and that what's done for you is foreplay, no, pussy-centered lovemaking, the foreplay is the real play. That is the play. Everything else is just incidental, that he comes into you or comes at all. It's just incidental, but it will be on a higher plane of conscious lovemaking than he's ever experienced, or maybe he has experienced before, he just didn't know how he got there. Now he's in the driver's seat, okay? Give him that power, give him that gift by explaining this to him, okay? He deserves it. You deserve it though, honey. You're the one that deserves it. Come on, you've had enough of regular run-of-the-mill sexing. I can't even call it lovemaking because it's boring without your orgasmic sensations. Multi-orgasmic sensations are in you. And if those aren't happening, honey, in those little teeny little spasmodic clitoral orgasms that are just like from all that friction, oh, it's just such a... It's just, I'd rather read a good book. I kind of would, you know, because otherwise I don't get so tired. And I'm sure he would too. He's like, oh God, I've done enough of that, or I didn't go play ball. And then your relationship's over early. You're like, oh, we thought we had the chemistry, but no, guess we don't. No, all you did wrong is you did cock-centered lovemaking, which doesn't last that long. In the end, it burns both people out, and it's not exciting enough, and it's not, because it's not the wild realm of surrender and uncontrollable sensation that is the gift of the goddess, that when you go to the place where you didn't even know you had those sensations, it's all about focusing on the pussy as the main deal, okay? Slow it down. Don't go inside. Feel the exterior rose for a long time, okay? Much love, darling. I hope this helps. Yeah. Love life.